In this video, we'll cover the basics of how specifications are organized and show you some of the most important items to look for that could cost you money if you were to miss them. We'll show you how to save time and learn how to quickly review a spec for the items most needed during an estimating takeoff. First, you need to know that most construction specifications follow the CSI format, which is divided up by divisions, just like chapters in a book. CSI stands for the Construction Specifications Institute. Each division covers a specific trade, specialty, or contract requirement. The specifications are broken down into 50 divisions. Some of them are not being used and they're reserved for later expansion, but you'll see division 00 it starts with, and this is procurement and contracting requirements, which is important to read, and division 01 general requirements. So we'll go over some of these later, but you'll see the different trades down here. If you do concrete, you'll be division 03. If you do masonry work, division 04. And we get down to our MEP trades. Division 22 is plumbing. It's always Division 22. Division 23 is heating, ventilating, and air conditioning, known as HVAC. Always Division 23. And Division 26 is electrical. Now, if you do additional work, you may do site work. That would be over here in the Division 31 to 35. Or if you do process work, Division 40 to 48, which you got process, heating, cooling, and drying equipment, or water and wastewater equipment, depending on what your plumbing company does, your HVAC company, or your electrical company does, you'll have other divisions. But your main categories, your MEP is division 22, 23, and 26. So as you can see, plumbing is 22. Everything starts with your two digits in the specs. We'll always start with 22 if you're in plumbing. We'll always start with 23 if you do HVAC, and we'll always start with 26. Now, it has three levels of that spec number is broken up into three levels of six digits. Each level has two digits. Now, we already learned the first set of digits is the division. Now, we'll see what the second set is. So, division 22, which is plumbing, level 1 will indicate that. The next level will indicate, in this case, sanitary sewage. But we know there's more to sanitary sewage than just sanitary sewage. So that's where you get level 3. That defines the third set of numbers. In this case, facility, sanitary sewers, sanitary waste and vent. They all fall under the main category there, sanitary sewage. But as you see, that third level defines it better. Sanitary waste piping is still level 1, 22, plumbing, level 2, sanitary sewage, but level 3 is more definitive. Sanitary waste interceptors all falls under sanitary waste. Now the same for HVAC, level 1. 23, that's your division. Division 23 is always HVAC. But level 2, this is talking about packaged water chillers. So the second set of numbers is 64, and that's where you'll find packaged water chillers. But we all know there's more than one type of packaged water chiller. So that's where level 3 comes in. Defines the type of packaged water chiller. In this case, absorption, centrifugal, reciprocating, scroll, and rotary screw. So level 1 is your division, HVAC, level 2 is packaged water chillers, and level 3 is more definitive of these packaged water chillers because there's more than one type. Division 26, electrical, level 1 is your division. And if we want to talk about interior lighting, that's the second level, that's category 51. But we all know there's more to interior lighting than just that. It has to be broken down in level 3. That's your third set of numbers. Incandescent, fluorescent, LED, HID interior lighting. So once again, level one is always your division. In this case, 26 is electrical. Level two is defining interior lighting. And level three defines it even further because there's more than one type of interior lighting. Now, those are the main levels. You can get another level, and that is to break down those levels even further. So the engineers will put a period and then another set of numbers. In this case, the sanitary waste piping specialties has more than one items under it. Sanitary drains, fats, oils, and grease disposal systems, and grease removal devices. So it's another way of defining further that category. Same with chillers. Centrifugal water chillers, the last one there, 236416. Well, there's air-cooled and water-cooled centrifugal chillers. So it's a way to break down the category further. So after you have those categories, within those categories, you'll have three parts. Part one, part two, and part three. And those three parts are the same in every division and in every category. It's always the same. Three parts. Part one, general. And what that does is gives a description of that section of the scope. It references any related spec sections. So it can reference another spec section within your division or another spec section outside your division. Quality assurance, submittal requirements, publications and standards. So all this falls under part one. And this gets repeated over and over again in each division category. Now, product, it's going to describe the product and the performance requirements of the product, the material requirements. This is where the meat of the spec will be in addition to the standards. And then execution is just about what it says. Installation requirements, your fabrication, your installation requirements, any required startup and testing, and training of owner's staff. So you have a general part one, which is just an overall description and referencing standards and publications. And then you got part two, which really describes the product and the performance requirements, what it's got to do, how it's got to perform, if it's made of stainless, aluminum, all those requirements are there. And then execution is about putting it in, how you put it in, how you start it up, how you test it, and then training the owner. Those are the same in every section of the spec. Now here's an example. This is part one general, and it's about ductwork. So you can see part one general description. It describes the ductwork. It's talking about supply and return, outside air, exhaust ducts, and then definitions, defines, standards. And then you got sill and the same, there you go. You got related work. See, it's relating to other sections of the spec that are applicable to you. And here's your products. So it's going to describe, there's the material type, galvanized steel. Here's some classes of stainless steel, right? And here's execution. So it's telling you how fabricate and install ductwork and accessories in accordance with referenced SMACNA standards. SMACNA standards is the Sheet Metal and Air Conditioning National Association, which puts out methods, materials and methods for installing and fabricating ductwork. So there you go. That's the execution part. One last thing we want to cover is some of the important items that you should be looking for in the specifications. And you should have a form in your spreadsheet. This one is in the MEP Academy estimating spreadsheet. where you can list the spec section and the requirements. So this here is for division 00, which is the first division in the specifications, and it's for procurement and contracting requirements. So these are important things to know. Is there a mandatory pre-bid meeting or job walk date and time? You want to make sure you record that. Is a bid bond required? So you want to make sure you order that in time, that it gets delivered before the bid date. Performance and payment bonds, you want to make sure to cover the cost if that's required. Liquidated damages, this is for damages caused for usually for a schedule that is not completed on time. Project schedule, this is goes to the first one we just mentioned there. Start and finish date to see if you can finish within that time. You got the labor force to man up the schedule. Addendums, any addendums, alternates, shop drawing requirements, and then the bid forms. You want to make sure you fill out the bid forms complete. Some jobs will reject your proposal if you don't complete all the bid forms as requested. And then the RFI, request for information deadline. What is the last date on which you can submit a question to get answer and clarification on the contract documents? And then you'll have individual sheets. I'll show you the sheet metal spec review one that we have in the MEP Academy estimating spreadsheet. And this, you should go ahead and list the most common costly items that you want to look for in the specs. And so for like sheet metal, you got remote damper operators. Is duct leakage testing required? If so, you would list the spec section here, whatever that section would be. I'm just going to put something random here. And then I would put the page number that you found it on. So this is for easy reference. So you do that throughout these: duct smoke detectors, continuously welded round fittings. Of course, that's going to be expensive. Duct lining, are there any requirements for duct lining or duct cleaning? Here's the liquidated damages again. Boiler flue, joint seams, the types that are allowed or prohibited. So you should have one of these forms for each trade that you bid, and have the description of the most common costly items that you want to remind your estimators to be looking for, and have them document the spec section.